helpful bill to the House.
I call Madame Davidson.
Madam Speaker, on behalf of the Green Party, we will not be supporting the Waimea Water Augmentation Scheme Bill. I want to acknowledge the merits that have been raised by other members of this House. We simply are a voice for those and the reasons that many locals have opposed this bill. I wanted to pick up, firstly, this is second reading, so I went through the report back from the Governance and Administration Committee. I agree with other ratepayers and citizens who highlighted that it was quite difficult to get an accurate number of exactly how many submissions were opposed and in support. There were apparently 137 written submissions, and then the report from the committee sort of went through groups and names of organisations who were in support, but I wasn't able to get any clear understanding of the weight. And I know there were, I've already heard through some of the members that there were locals who were opposed to this, but I'm not part of that committee. I wasn't able to get a clearer sense than that. And so I agree with those submitters who went back and also read the report back from the committee and were concerned that they also couldn't find that clarity. So a number of reasons we cannot be convinced to give our support to this bill. Yes, there are long-standing water issues in that region, but for the Green Party, we will always ask what is the cause of the cause of the cause of the cause of those water issues, and we will always want to go back to looking actually at sustainable water supply, at water storage and allocation issues, and actually the core economic infrastructure that has led to some of the dilapidation of aqua tables and water tables in the first place. And I think that's part of the admirable position that I'm really proud to be able to take today, is actually wanting to look at what is truly, truly behind some of those long-standing water issues. And we feel strongly, and again, I acknowledge the different characteristics and dynamics of this particular dam. Of course, everyone knows that the Greens have been clearly vocal and have it actually in our confidence and supply agreement that we generally oppose large-scale irrigation plans. So this will be not as this will be no surprise to any member in the House. However, we...
Mr. Eagle, order. Mr. Eagle, would you resume your seat? Thank you.
Madam Davidson. Just giving a really, really brilliant speech there, Mr. Eagle. however, I do acknowledge that certain dynamics of this particular augmentation scheme have been put on the floor tonight about what different reasons about why this is particularly different for a large-scale and commercial irrigation scheme. So I'm not even going to pretend that I haven't heard those reasons. However, there are still a number of valid concerns that we hold and that I'm happy to stand here and represent on today. I did want to pick up on, you know, I will say that I am pleased to see from the Tasman District Council in its submission and in the workings of this bill that the council will make biodiversity estimate, and that the council will make as part of its resource consent condition for the dam around protecting diversity rates. And I did want to raise that's one of the wider and longer term concerns that the Greens absolutely will have as part of this augmentation scheme. Just recently we had the UN Convention on Biological Diversity, I think just last week actually, held in Egypt, and that convention and that meeting of parties wants to see ambitious global targets in the next 2 years to protect the organisms that are vital for global food production, clean water and the removal of carbon from the atmosphere. And I wanted to raise that because with schemes like these, we need to be absolutely clear without any doubt that we are not going to continue to contribute to the ongoing loss of plant and animal diversity on Earth. A fundamental worldwide extinction crisis is happening and has been happening. And actually, there's lesser awareness of this, I believe, generally, than there is to climate change. Coming back to the bill, this is what I wanted to raise as one of our reasons for opposing. This extinction crisis is deepening every year, and we are severely impacted by it. And in New Zealand, of course, I acknowledge the Council's biodiversity investment, we're losing our Indigenous biodiversity at an alarming rate. So I saw that the Council will make these investments, and we will want to keep a check on this. We will want to keep an ongoing monitor of the types of resource consent conditions that the Council are proposing they will make. For example, the salvage, propagation and establishment of at least 3 new populations of the nationally rare New Zealand shovel mint. These are the sorts of precautions that the Green Party will be keeping an absolute monitor on, and it goes to the core of some of our concerns with this scheme. So I really did want, and I know that not many of the other members in the House have picked up on, particularly on the concern for biodiversity. So that was one of the main points that I wanted to raise. I acknowledge the various thoughts, and I believe it was one of the original reasons why there was a no vote from Council. The concerns about the funding model, and I also understand that because of those very concerns that the funding model was changed. But still, even with that change of the funding model, some locals and people of that region and community are still concerned with the sheer, the equitability and the distribution and who will be picking up the tabs. And I acknowledge that over the long scheme of things, that may not be we can say it may not seem like a huge, huge amount for individual ratepayers, but I think people are also concerned at the council and ratepayer overall investment. So I acknowledge those concerns as well. Of course, there is... Oh, gosh, that went. Of course, there is the situation of using conservation land for commercial purposes, and that we absolutely want to remain cautious on that, and very principally so, on that as an issue. I understand that this has been picked up for two reasons as being viable to push through that conservation land, because it is lesser conservation value, and also because it's being seen as a pragmatic solution. And I just want to make sure that we actually get that balance right. That we are actually truly understanding the transformation of the economic model that we have operated on all around the country to date, and whether or not we have got that right in this augmentation scheme. So, Madam Speaker, those were some of the main rationales for the Greens' opposition to this bill that I am very proud to put on the floor in this House tonight, but particularly picking up on the fact that there was not clear mandate and consensus from all of the local community, and that there was actually clear local opposition to this bill. And I stand absolutely to acknowledge that opposition and the reason that they raised their opposition. The Greens we understand that this will make the passage through the House because it's got the numbers, but we will be keeping check on all of the valid concerns that we are raising, and particularly into the future of this development, including the financial monitoring of how this budget, whether it blows out or not, and who ends up bearing the impact on that. Thank you, Madam Speaker.
Speaker.
I call Maureen Pugh.
Thank you very much, Madam Speaker.